Write this down quick. Love is a force generated by a decision. Love has no feelings, you know. Wow. If God responded to you the way he felt about what you did to him, you wouldn't be redeemed today. Now this is important because, see, true love has no feelings. It's a choice. If you wait on feelings, remember now, feelings are chemical. And chemicals change every 5 seconds. So if I love you because I feel like I love you, you might lose your love in 5 minutes. You ever heard this? We fell out of love. We don't love each other anymore. What that means is the chemicals changed. The way I used to feel when I look at you, you don't look that way no more, so I don't get to feel it no more. You bigger, fatter, heavier, you know, you change on me. After 5 children, you don't look the same. Some women are under so much pressure to try and keep their husband's eyes on them that the stress is causing the woman to get cancer. Just the stress. Because that man doesn't know what love is. He starts saying things like, why don't you look like Cheryl? You put on too much weight, you know. You look at this picture 10 years ago. And then you see, and they start putting pressure on you. That man need beaten by me. Bring him to me. I will whoop him. Because he forgot that his stomach is now bigger than his chest. And his head receded. And his breath smelled worse. Sometimes we forget that we change too. Say amen anyhow. Praise the Lord. Love is a choice. You choose to love. Make a note of this, please. Very important. Love is an act of the will. That should be love. Love is what? An act of the will. Say it with me. Love is an act of the will. I beg you to please write that down. Because we keep thinking that love is some emotional concoction deep in the soul. Love is an act of the will. You can decide to love your enemy. If you don't believe me, ask Jesus. He said, love your enemy. And he made a command. You obey a man, command out of a will. Love those who hate you, he says. Love those who despitefully use you. Love those who persecute you. How can you do that? It has to be a decision. That's the kind of love you need for marriage. Because the person you marry will be an enemy twice a week. Maybe twice a day. People will do things in your life that hurt your expectations. But you got to decide. I still love you. If Jesus said to love your enemies, then the person you couldn't get along with, you decided not to love them. Write this down. Love is a debt you owe. Boy, that's tough. Let me read where that came from, all right? Because love is really a law. Laws have no feelings. What did I say? Laws have no feelings. Love is a law. Sometimes you feel like running the red light because you're late. But the law says stop. Your feelings got nothing to do with this law. Do you know that if you love your children, you will chasten them? Sometimes you feel for your son so you don't whip him. The Bible says he that doesn't chasten his son hates him. You can't get your feelings in the middle of discipline. If you love the person and they did wrong, you discipline them. It has to be a will. I love you so much, I feel like not spanking you, but I'm going to whoop you. Why? Because I love you so much, I don't want you to go this way. This is the wrong way to go. It's love. Look at them. A That's your dream, eh? We dream that that's what we're going to be like. But let me wake you up real quick. John chapter 13, verse 34. Everybody read together. Read. A new commandment I give to you. Love one another as I have loved you, so that you must love one another. By this will all men know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. Look at Romans 13, verse 8. I want you to read this out loud together. Romans 13, verse 8. It says what? Let no debt remain outstanding except the continuing debt to love one another. For he who loves his fellow man has fulfilled the law of God. It's a debt. I owe you to love you. Most of the time when you owe people, you don't feel like paying them. You don't feel like paying them. Talk to me. When that light bill comes, you don't feel like paying the light bill. When the time to pay the mortgage, you don't feel like paying the mortgage. You don't feel debt. But you choose, based on your integrity, to pay the bill. That's why you love people. You are obligated. Try and take feelings out of your marriage, please. I know this sounds crazy. It's good to feel good, you know, but just monitor that. Don't mix it up with love. Because it doesn't work. Let me show you how deep this is. Look at John 13, 34. Read. A new commandment I give unto you. What he says. Love one another as I have loved you. So you must love one another. John 15, 12. Read. My commandment is this. Love each other as I have loved you. He keeps repeating it. It's a law. It's a law. I command it. You don't feel like this. Verse 13. Greater love had no man than this, than a man laying on his life for his friends. Oh man, listen to the words. John 15, 17, read. This is my command, that you love one another. John 14, 15, he says, if you love me, you'll obey what I command you, and that is to love one another. He said, if you love me, you will love people who hate you. You will do good to those who abuse you, who despitefully use you. You will still decide, I love you. Love. Let's talk about where does love come from? I'm talking about real love now, not agape. I mean, not asterigo and phileo and eros. Eros from the word erotic. Is you want that sexual pornography stuff? That's erotic. That's eros. That's flesh love. Don't get mixed up with that. Don't ever consider sex love. They are never the same. If someone tells you they love you, and therefore you shall let them sleep with you and have sex, that person does not love you. You can't equate that with love. Matter of fact, they call sex in this society making love. Making it. That means it doesn't exist. We got to make it. Let's make love. What do you mean make love? That means you don't got it. That's exactly what they mean. And they make it for 45 seconds. Over. And then they don't want to talk to you anymore for weeks. It's not love. Why are you all quiet during this series? I don't know what's going on. Make a note of this. Galatians 5. It says, the entire law is summed up in a single command. Love your neighbor as yourself. Galatians 5, 22. It says, but the fruit of the Spirit is what? Is love. Love is not a gift. It is a fruit of the Spirit. There's no gift of love in the Bible. Either it is in you by God's grace, or you ain't got it. Thank you.
Thank you.